It's very good to see and have you here in this seminar. I am Jaehoon. I'm a lecturer and also the managing director in Korean Technopark. Now, I transformed myself from Korean Technopark managing director to venture capitalist. I started a new job in the private sector from public sector. Today, I'd like to give an important and also very instructive lecture about Korean Technopark, which is a Korean version of Science and Technology Park. Also, it's the most successful invention created by Korean government in the last almost 50 years. As well, it is also one of the most successful science and technology park around the world. So, it's not the theoretical lecture, but it's experiential and also very learning by doing a lecture based on my previous almost 20 years experience in the Korean Technopark project. I think this project will help you to promote and develop your region, especially your economy. Korean TP model, in short KTP model, is very popular around the world, especially in the developing countries, because it was very, successful invention to promote and develop regional economy or industry. So many developing countries wanted us to export or transfer our successful experience to them. That's why we already exported our experience to Ethiopia, Uzbekistan, Guatemala, and also in Kazakhstan in some sense. I think you will get something from today's my lecture, because Korean Technopark model is not far away from you, like the Silicon Valley, Ulu, or other very advanced countries science park model. Korean Technopark model is very close to you, under your reach. So if you take my lecture today, then you will easily apply our model to your region. So you will be very lucky. Hi guys, I will start my lecture. My lecture is composed of three sessions. But the first session will last almost 30 minutes. It's about why Korean Technopark was created or established, what are the major functions, and also what contributed it to the Korean economy and also regional economy and industry. Before I start my lecture, as you may notice, my very interesting my career. Actually, now I'm giving a lecture about Korean Technopark, which is almost the public sector sense. But now I work for one venture capital, which is in public sector. Why? I transformed myself from public guy to private venture capitalist, money managers. I will tell you why I transformed my career from public to private later, okay? Anyhow, I have been in Technopark project almost 17 years, over 22 years in the Korean Technopark whole history. I am the longest career man in the Korean Technopark. So that's why I can give you the whole or the overall picture of Korean Technopark, why it was created, and also what a major role and what contributed, and also where it should go. I mean, the future picture of Korean Technopark. Okay, let's go. Before Korean Technopark was implemented, Korean government was faced with foreign currency crisis. It is the East Asian foreign current crisis. I mean, the dollar shortage in 1997. Almost all Eastern Asian countries, Korea, Taiwan, Malaysia, Indonesia, almost all East Asian countries, even Singapore, were afflicted with the dollar shortage. All of those countries were almost broke in dollar shortage. That's why Korean government was not an exception in the dollar shortages. At that time, Korean government realized, oh, we cannot support the big or large firms in Korean sense, it's jebol, or in English sense, term, conglomerate. We cannot support those organizations because those organizations were almost went broke. You may be familiar or you may not, but this organization, Daewoo, is an automaker, which is the second largest automaker in Korea next to Hyundai. And also it's the second largest conglomerate in Korea next to Samsung at that time. But it could not sustain itself at that time because of the money shortage. So Korean government could not support. Oh, let it go. You should go broke. That's why the syndrome or the myth, the too big to fail syndrome was destroyed at that time. Before this foreign currency crisis, many Korean large firms or even Korean people thought, if we make our organization larger and larger and bigger, government will not let us or let ourselves go broke. But Korean government could not at that time. That's why this myth of too big to fail was destroyed. So therefore, Daewoo conglomerate, Kia Motors, this not current Hyundai Kia, the old Kia, it's the third largest Korean automaker, also went broke. So many people lost their jobs. Also, many families were destroyed. Everything in Korean business circle had changed at that time because of the foreign currency crisis. That's why Korean government realized, oh, the big organization cannot help in this crisis. Rather, the small and medium enterprises might help Korean economy in this foreign currency crisis. That's why Korean government, paid attention to supporting and developing small and medium enterprise. Be what? Be Korean Technopark. Korean Technopark is specialized in supporting, helping small and medium enterprise to grow and develop. That's why Korean Technopark was established to support small and medium enterprise in Korean economy. Yes, it worked out. That's why Korean Technopark project was regarded as one of the most successful Korean government project. Now even it is also regarded one of the most successful science and technology around the world. You see this lecture, this graph, all indices dropped, plummeted because of the foreign currency crisis. Okay, still you may be a little bit puzzled. What is Technopark? It's not technology park. Even it's not technology. Why you named it technology park instead of technopark? But Korean people or even and Japanese people like to short the terms. That's why we made it technopark, technology plus park. It's not different as technology park. You may be also very familiar with this very similar terminology, high tech cluster. Technopark, Research Park, Science Park, Technology Park, Technopole, Technopolis, Science City, Cyber City, High Tech City, Research and Development Park. Everything is almost the same. It functions in a similar way, but each country has its own name, or they may coin their own names. Anyhow, Korean Technopark has evolved in these four stages. In the first stage, Korean Technical Park played as infra provider, infra supporter, infra by building spaces, also buying and renting expensive equipment to small and medium enterprise. That's why many small and medium enterprises could house themselves in this techno park by using the space and also expensive equipment. Then, Korean government also asked techno park to bridge the gaps between university and also industries. I will give you in more detail later. And then Korean government realized, oh, this techno park project was quite worked out very well. So while the local government were not able to, well, were not capable of creating their regional industrial policy or economic policy. That's why Korean government also asked the techno park to play as regional policymakers, of course, according to the central government, appropriate to the central government requirement or central government guidelines. And then now it has been evolved to platform. You know, platform. If you go to the train station and go to the certain platform, you don't have to worry about. Just if you take a train there, then your train will leave for the designated destination. That is the platform. So now Technopark play as a platform. If small and medium enterprise or startup comes, then they don't, the startups or so small and medium enterprise don't have to worry about what they need. Just the Technopark will provide the necessary services, necessary functions to small and medium. That's why Technopark play as a platform by nurturing local economies and also developing, fostering knowledge-based hidden champion, small and strong startups. These are actually all of the Korean Technopark's four stages. Of course, these four stages is not developed or is not evolved sequentially, but these all four stages can work concurrently. In some sense, in some times sequentially, but in many times concurrently, these two stages can can take place at the same time, or these two stages can take place at the same time. It depends on the regional economy, economical environment or situation. Okay, here I'd like to emphasize one important. 여기가 아니고. 아, 그게 메인 거예요.
네, 이게 메인입니다.
예. Here, I'd like to emphasize why Korean Technopark was so successful. And also, I hope you will adopt our tactic or our strategy in implementing your Technoparks. Actually, as in any country, in any time, policy worked. That in that policy, politics worked. That's why as regime changes, the changed regime or changed power group may implement their own policies. That's why even the most successful policies cannot last long over regimes. In that case, how can you protect such changes or such drop, such giving up of the successful policies? It is maybe the best way is to enact or making a law. That's why we at that time we realized at that point. So we persuaded Korean lawmakers to enact a special law for protecting and supporting Korean Technopark project. That law is called Act on Special Cases Concerning Support for Tekken Park was in 1998. This is the strategy, confidentiality of the Korean Tekken Park project success. So this, still this law is effective. It will be effective later. So you have to pay attention to the making this kind of law in order to make your Tekken Park or Science and Technology Park successful in the long time. Of course, the major task of Tekken Park is, as I explained already, in the four stages, facilitate an industrial system or UIG, tech incubator, building provider, and also training marketing, etc. Almost these are in the first stage and second stage of Korean Tekken Park functions. So actually, these two functions, business incubator function for supporting new startups, housing them and supporting and promoting them. And then these incubated firms cannot afford to buy or cannot afford to keep expensive equipment. That's why these infrastructure provider function is important in supporting such small and medium enterprises. Okay, these slide shows the four stages more specifically and even including in time or period. Korean Tekken Park, as I explained, have gone four stages of development. The first stage is 1998 to 2002. It's a kind of incipient or starting period in the Korean Tekken Park project as infra build or business incubator. Then Korean Tekken Park was evolved or asked to bridge the gaps university, industry, government. In other words, it was asked to play as UIG facilitator because each institution, university, had its own objectives. Industry has its own objective, basically money making or profit making. Government has its own objectives to make people happy equally. So each institution has its own objectives which are conflicting each other. In that case, there should be some third sector organization to accommodate its objectives and also compromise its objectives. And then they will cooperate with each other. This role was assigned to Tekken Park. And then Korean Tekken Park was also asked by Korean central government to make deal the local government or local municipal government's insufficiency of policy making as policy maker and also vision provider for its own region. It ranges from 2003 to 2012. At this period, Korean Tekken Park was most fully and most abundantly supported by Korean government. But later, it has also developed, make it platform role, which are equipped with all the necessary SME supporting functions in Tekken Park itself. That is called platform business, regional integrated business platform roles here. So now these are all functions taking place simultaneously or concurrently, not sequentially. Anyhow, now we are here we are focused more focused on this platform functions. Anyhow, at this time, we were very much supported by Korean Computer. We were very lucky at this time. But now, Korean Computer is not less interested in supporting technology because Korean Computer is, you know, asked to support many institutions, not only Technopark, but also others. That's why Korean Computer cannot prioritize its support to Technopark only. Okay, in Korean Technopark, in the first stage, it is infra builder and also providers, space providers and equipment providers. And also, that's why it aimed to make it one-stop service organization by accumulating production function, business consulting, education and training, business incubating, and also R&D function in Technopark itself. All of these kind of functions were housed in Technopark. That if small medium enterprise wanted to get some support, or some function of this, then they come to Technopark, then they got serviced. We aimed, but this aim was not fully fulfilled. In some technology it was okay. Others it was not. Anyhow, we aimed. Secondly, as I told you, Korean Technopark was asked to bridge the gaps between each institutional objectives. That's why it was asked to play as UIG facilitators. You know, regional governments or central governments are very interested in creating jobs. But Technopark, university or industry are not that interested in creating jobs. Universities are interested in creating new R&D theories or producing graduates, while companies, industries are interested in profit making. So each three institutions have its own special objectives. Institutional, here, institutional conflict may take place. That's why Technopark was established to play as third sector, which is not inclined to a certain institution. It is very ideological, but in some sense it did not work. In other sense, it worked out. Anyhow, we worked at this UIG facilitator. You know, many countries, even in Korea, government has its own objective, entrepreneurial universities, regional innovation center, or business incubator has its own objectives. Research institutes are interested in R&D or theories. Enterprises are interested in profit making. But if Technopark plays well as facilitator, then it narrows the gaps between these institutions. Yes, now in 1990s, late 1990s, and even in early 2000s, these three institutions have pursued its own objective. But now, many universities are very willing to cooperate with industries as a part of industrial cooperation project. Also, governments are very, interested in supporting industries and also research universities. In the third stage, Korean government, as I told you earlier, it's the range, the period started from 2003 to 2012. Korean government were very interested in regionally balanced growth. I think your country may be similar to Korea. Your capital city is very well developed, far away developed than other regional areas. Korea is also very underdeveloped, unbalanced developed countries. If you go to Seoul, almost more than half population live in Seoul. And also more than 70% of economy are concentrated in Seoul. Very, you know, unbalanced developed and unproportionately developed between Seoul and other areas. This person who got power as president from 2002 to 2007, whose name is Nomu-hyun, was very interested in developing Korean nation in a balanced way. He prioritized the development of regional areas rather than Seoul and metropolitan areas. That's why he visited Daegu, where I used to live. I'm here. It was almost 15 years ago. Now I'm, 62 years old. At this time, I was 42, much younger than now. Okay? I'm a little bit ashamed not to keep this young appearance up to now. Anyhow, this lady was First Lady Kwon Yang-suk, and this person was the mayor of Daegu City. Anyhow, this picture, this slide shows how much Korean president emphasized the importance of technoparks in regional economy and industrial development by inviting me next to him. You know, how powerful people is measured by the distance of the power man, the president and the person. I was very close to the president at this time. Anyhow, this picture shows how president is interested in supporting and developing technopark project. Anyhow, at this time, Korean technopark was even more powerful than local government because it played as a regional development agency, very similar in the British Kingdom's RDA. Still, at this time, in the third stage, we aimed to, pursue to make the one-stop service organization, one-stop service institution, technoparks. Adding this policymaker too, plus this. Okay, now Korean technopark has, transformed or evolved to this platform role. Value creating interaction between startup SME and other SME or large firms. I'll show you why I mentioned here large firms. Many large firms visit Korean technoparks to cooperate with startups or SMEs in order to help their new industrial domain, find new industrial domains. In some sense, large or big organizations visit Korean technopark and locate very powerful and hidden champion SME. Then sometimes they gave big money in order to merge them to their organization. So anyhow, Korean technopark started this infrastructure provider and incubator. Then it was asked to form the RIG facilitator, and later regional development agent, and now also it should collaborate with other business supporting agencies in the region or in the Korean government. That's why these all functions are housed in Technopark to make Technopark platform or center for nurturing regional community in order to strengthen regional and national industry competitiveness. Now there are 19 technoparks in Korea. Actually, Gyeonggi has two, Gyeonggi Daejin and Gyeonggi Technopark. Gyeongbuk has two, Gyeongbuk Technopark and Pohang Technopark. Except for these two regions, each region has its own technopark. Even Seoul has its own technopark. New administrative capital city, Sejong has its own. That's why there are 17 provinces or regions in Korea. Nevertheless, now there are 19 because of the Gyeonggi and Gyeongbuk have two. Why? You may be a little bit puzzled. Why Seoul has its own technopark? But yes, Seoul has its own technopark, but Seoul technopark is not supported by the Korean government. Just it play, it function as a technopark, but it is not supported by the government like other regional technoparks. That is a little bit different technopark function in Seoul. Okay, in the first stage, it's 1997 and 1998. The six example technopark were designated and established. Incheon, Gyeonggi, Daegu, Gyeongbuk, Gwangju, Chungnam. The other regions realized, oh, technopark contribute to the regional economy. That's why other regions, then these six, asked Korean government to establish their own. That's why in Chungbuk, Jeonbuk, Jeonnam, Gwangwon were established in 2003. Jeju Island were, Technopark were established in 2010. Even new administration capital city, Sejong, asked Korean government to establish their, its own. That's why Sejong were established in 2018, just only a year ago. If you look at these slides, these slides shows summary statistics about how Korean technopark were successful in the last almost 20 or 21 years. Look at this one. Tenant company were almost only 32 in 1998. Now, almost 2,100 companies are doing their business in Technopark in 2019. Almost how much times? Almost 150 times. Look at the employees whom the tenant company had. It at 1998, 545, now almost 30,000. Look at this sales, now almost $13 billion. How much companies went public in the Korean stock market? At this time, zero. In 2019, 62 companies went public in the Korean stock market. It was very, very successful, SME supporting organization in the Korean economic and policies. You know, this data shows 19 technoparks budget and also employees. Total budget is almost $14 billion. And 40 employees work for the 19 technoparks. Maybe the budget, the largest budget technopark is this one, Gyeongnam. Sejong may be the smallest. How about staff members? Incheon Technopark employs 270 staffs. Sejong has only 43. These are the summary stats of Korean 19 technoparks. Okay, here I'm about to close the first session. Before I close, I conclude, I'd like to give you some three keys if you have the correct answer or win this quiz, then you'll get some nice Korean mobile phone or other. Anyhow, okay, the first key one is what makes Korean Technopark so successful and especially sustainable? Korean culture, participant passion, government budget, or special law? Guess. Question two, over the four evolving stages, which the latest one? Infra builder, UIG facilitator, vision provider, or business platform? It's very easy. I think it's easy if you had paid attention to my lecture. These two questions are very easy. Also, the latest question, if your memory, evades. How many technoparks are in Korea now? Very easy question. 6, 12, 18, 19. Okay, I hope you'll get all three right question answered. Then you'll get the win the quiz. Okay? You must have a little bit, paid attention to this lecture. Then you wasted your energy, so you have to take some rest. Thank you for your attention. Thank you.